Hey, what's up, YouTube? Mac here, and I'm here with a quick and easy 5-minute Zerg versus Protoss opener. Probably gonna do more of these, like, shorter 5-minute videos, but without further ado, let's get into the game. So, very, very standard opener. You go for 16 hatch, 17 gas, 18 pull, as you see I am doing right now. So I'm gonna make it not fall on my camera so it doesn't trip you guys out a bit. First 100 gas, you put into Zergling speed. The next, when you get to 40 or 50 gas, we will see in a second, you take one drone out of gas, and then you put it into, or build an Evo chamber with it. So, around 40 to 50, Evo chamber. Keep in gas with the two, not a third one. Get a third base at around 30 to 31 supply. Plus one, build an overlord. Start it down here. Drone up your main slash natural. Make sure you have 16 out of 16 on mineral saturation. You can even drone up a little bit on your third base too. I prefer to do that most of the time, but sometimes you want to get the aggression going earlier, even if you don't have plus one at the time. You would do this in reaction to a Stargate opener most of the time. It's not that strong against Charge Lot and Adept openers. But also has some strength against some blink DT or blink stalkers and some effectiveness against DTs. If you use your first 100 gas after you get melee in Zergling speed to make a lair, you can defend Dark Templar openers with an Overseer quite easily. It's only dealing with the Archons after that where it gets very difficult. So you just put on aggression before you get your plus one done, try and kill any shield batteries, maybe pick off a unit here and there. Kind of like weaken their defenses for your actual attacks to start happening. And once your bases are saturated at your main and natural, you have some queens on the way. That's when you start flooding Zerglings. Maybe squeak out a few drones after you make your initial wave. And then during all of your aggression, you're going to want to be making some drones. Make sure your economy is starting to push ahead of theirs. And then you can transition to whatever you want. I prefer to stay on this tech or to go into queens afterwards. You would go, if you're going to go the queen path, you go melee, carapace, plus one missile with your lair finishing soon. And maybe go plus two carapace if they're going for carriers, or plus two attack if they're staying on void rays. So, as you can see, I'm still just flooding Zerglings in, trying to deactivate any defenses, try and see if it's weaker over here. Maybe if they're going for a fourth base, we check there. Constantly try trading. You don't want to let them get like a huge ball of units, because that's when Zerglings lose their effectiveness. They're really good on smaller amounts of units where you can get like nice full surrounds on them. If they do start making Archons though, you will not find too much success most of the time. I have found some success actually going Neural Parasite against Archons if I'm staying on Zerglings. Get a few infestors, mix them in, but usually you want to go outside of that in order to get an actual reliable comp working. Zerglings are pretty fun, but they're not great against Archons, is basically what I'm trying to say. So you should start your transition once you see you can get no more damage done. You can go into whatever you want from there. Anyways, that's it. Let me know if you guys want any other sort of guides in the future, tutorials on certain playstyles, whatever. I'll do my best to provide small, short, concise videos about it. And I'll see you guys next time. Please like and subscribe to the video. If you want to help me even more, share it with your friends, or maybe even comment on the video for the algorithm. And as always, have a good night. Stay safe. And that's it from me. See you guys next time. Oh, I also stream. Watch my stream if you want to see this in action from Grandmaster Player. The guy I'm doing this against, Rom, is a 5.9k player, so this is not just good against people that are not Grandmaster, okay? This is a Grandmaster player, and I've beaten him with this build before. I didn't win this game, but I did beat him with this build earlier in the week, so. Just gonna dab on him. Anyways, that's it. See you guys. Bye.